Hello and welcome to my channel. This is what we are going to create today. Let's see how to create this using After Effects. Before further proceeding, I would like to thank you for supporting me. If you are new to this channel, please do consider subscribing. That would be highly appreciated. Please don't skip the video. Please do watch the video completely. Let's not waste any more of the time. Let's get started. I have imported some stock image files and some footages. I will leave a link of the website for the footages I have imported. Create a new composition and name it as main. I am choosing a 1920x1080 composition with the frame rate of 30 and a duration of 6 seconds. Create another composition and name it as sequence with the same composition settings. Now in the sequence composition, create a text layer and type in your text. I am typing in the man. Design your text as you wish. Align the text to the center of the composition. Pre-compose the text layer. Name it as text. Make sure you click on the move all attributes. Create a white solid layer and bring that down below the text layer. Change the track matte to alpha matte text layer. Duplicate the text layer and turn on its visibility. From the project panel, bring in the texture file into the composition. Now change the track matte to alpha matte text layer. Scale it down a bit. Select the first two layers and right click and select pre-compose. Name the composition as textured text. Duplicate the text layer and turn on its visibility. Search for drop shadow effect from the effects and presets panel and apply it into the duplicated layer. From the project panel, bring in the text layer to the timeline. Set the blending mode to add. Search for simple choker effect and apply it into the text layer. Set the choke matte to 5. Search for tint effect and apply it into the text layer. Set the map white to color to black. Search for rough and edges effect and apply it into the text layer. Set the edge type to photocopy. Search for drop shadow effect and apply it into the same layer. Set the opacity to 80. Duplicate this text layer and change the blending mode to overlay. Delete the simple choker effect and also change the map white to color from black to gray color. In the rough and edges effect, set the edge type to rusty. Set the border to 15 and also delete the drop shadow effect and duplicate the rough and edges effect. Change the edge type to cut and the border value to 40. From the project panel, bring in the text layer one more time and apply the simple choker effect and set the choke matte to 5. Now change the track matte of the below lying text layer to alpha matte text layer. Duplicate the first text layer and turn on its visibility. Search for tint effect and apply into the layer. Change the map white to color from white to black. Search for drop shadow effect and apply it into the same layer. Set the blending mode to overlay. Create a new light with the default settings, click on OK. Before that I should have changed all the layers to 3D, that's why there's a warning. So select all the layers and make them 3D. Now adjust the position of the light as you wish. Select all the layers and right click and click on pre-compose. Name the composition as title comp. Bring in the text composition to the timeline one more time and rename it to text shadow. Search for tint effect and apply it into the shadow layer. Set the map white to color to black. Search for CC radial blur effect and apply it into the shadow layer. Set the type to fading zoom and set the amount to 50. Change the blur center to something that of above the text layer. search for drop shadow effect and apply it into the shadow layer. Set the opacity to 100% and set the distance to 10. Set the direction to 180 degrees and set the softness to 5. Duplicate this drop shadow effect. Bring in the background image into the timeline and search for tint effect and apply it into the background layer. Search for curves effect and apply it into the background layer. Change the curves as shown. Search for sharpen effect and apply it into the background layer. Set the sharpen amount to 50. Create a new black solid layer. Bring the solid layer above the background layer. Name it as fake light. Create a mask like this with whatever tool you wish. Feather a bunch and also use the expansion. Create another solid layer and name it as fade. Set the solid color to white and click OK. Set the opacity to 5%. Bring in the smoke stock footage into the timeline. Set the blending mode to screen. Scale it according to the composition. Also bring in the dust file and scale it down to suit the composition. Set the blending mode to screen. Also bring in the sparks footage file and place it as you wish. I'm scaling it up a bit. Trim the spark file for about 1 second so that it looks natural. Bring in the particles file and set the blending mode to screen. Set the opacity to 25%. Also bring in the bokeh stock image file and scale it down a bit to suit the composition. Create a mask like this and feather a bunch around 500 or 600. Also use the mask expansion. Search for tint effect and apply it into the bokeh stock image file. Set the opacity value to 10%, okay, 5% will be good. Create a new camera. I am choosing a 50mm preset. Select the title composition and the shadow composition and make them 3D. Also make the background layer 3D layer. Also turn on the motion blur for these three layers. Bring up the position and rotation property of the camera layer. At around 2 second mark, create a keyframe for the position values and the Z rotation value. At the start of the timeline, increase the Z value so that the composition looks very near to the camera. Set the Z rotation value to 30 degrees. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Select the smoke layer and drag it to around 20 frames so that it looks nice with the animation. Set the smoke opacity value to 40%. Go to the main composition and bring in the sequence composition. Create a new adjustment layer and name it as contrast. Apply the curves effect to the contrast layer and create a S curve. Create a new adjustment layer and name it as color correction. Apply the curves effect into the CC layer. Change the curves as you wish to create your desired color grading. Create a new solid layer and name it as 4 color. search for 4 color gradient and apply it into the 4 color layer. Change the color centers as you like. I am distancing more the color centers and set the opacity value to 5%. Now RAM preview this. Yeah, that's looking good. Let's see the output once again. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and also click on the bell icon so that you get notified as soon as I post the videos. Click on the like button and share it with your friends. Comment down if you have anything to ask. And once again, thanks for being here and supporting me. This is Raudran signing off.